Okay, rotations. For a rotation to be fast, you need to combine lean angle and steering angle. If you want to practice that, you can do that by splitting it up. So first you practice lean angle, you make rotations like you would normally do with a lot of lean angle and not a lot of steering lock yet. Then, if you master that, you can start practicing full lock turns. You don't have to pay attention to a lot of lean angle yet because you're focusing on the steering lock. You have to get used to making rotations while the handlebars are against the steering lock. So going less fast means you fall into the corner, and if you do that too much you fall off. So you have to go a little bit faster to get up again. That means you either have to go on the throttle or release the rear brake again. Once you master these full lock turns, so you are comfortable riding a full circle against full lock, you can start to combine the lean angle with the full lock again. So you make full lock turns and then you brake with the rear brake, so you fall into the corner, and then that means your lean angle becomes larger and then the rotations become smaller and smaller, maintaining that full lock. That's the theory behind it.
Okay.
I can now
demonstrate. Yes.
Demonstrate. This was just lean angle.
Okay.
Only for, this is not small, it's just lean angle. I'm trying to increase the lean angle that you can reach. So now I'm going to demonstrate the full lock and not concentrate on the lean angle.
All your balance is coming from the rear brake. All your balance is coming from the rear brake.
All my balance is from the rear brake. So now I will demonstrate if you combine the lean angle and
full lock. Yeah.
Also here I'm still regulating. Yes, that's my right foot. That's the rear brake. Like braking, falling into the corner, and then it's a little bit too much, and then releasing, but under full lock.